Azure Active Directory licensing. Do we really need to know about it? We absolutely do. As a solutions architect, you need to know what you need to pay for and what is it that you get for free. The business people and the stakeholders whom you'll be speaking with will really ask these questions. Do I really have to pay for all the rich features of Azure Active Directory and the security features like multi-factor authentication, conditional access, privilege identity management, or identity protection? I would encourage you to get familiar with the items that are listed here in this document. So let's say you're speaking with a company that is already using Azure AD and now wants to protect their identities. Then what type of license would they need? Maybe they need conditional access, but do not need risk-based conditional access. In this case, they can just work with P1 license. How about a scenario where they need to prevent against risk events, or they would like to use PIM, then they would need P2 licenses. Please take a look at this Microsoft article, and in this article, you would need to look at these headings and then map them against these columns. Everything that is checked under the free category will be available for free and you do not need any license. But anything that is not checked, for example, group access management or self-service password research for cloud users is available in Office 365 apps, P1 and P2. So you can start mapping these headers against the categories or against the licensing models. So this is a quick lesson on licenses, but make sure that you get familiar with the licenses and understand what falls under the free section and what falls under the Office 365 apps, P1 and P2 licensing models.